this is Deanna. Welcome to my channel, y'all. I am back working on to package up my dog Bandanas tonight. I am going to use the help of my new pink cute little Munbyn printer. Loving this thing. So I actually unboxed this last night on my channel, and let me just tell you, when I said I was taking everything out and I was gonna learn how to use it off camera, it didn't take me long at all. It was very, very simple. So when you open it up, it came with this right here, and all you had to do was scan that. This for a laptop. All you have to do is scan initial setup if you wanted to use the Bluetooth connection for mobile phones and tablets, which I put the app on my phone. I also have added the app to my iPad. So anyway, I really just, it didn't take me long at all to figure out how to play with it and how to use it. It was so simple. Now, if you don't know much about the Munbyn printers, these are thermal printers. There's no ink involved. So you do have to use like the thermal labels, and that's what I'm using here. I only have these pink labels. These are 4x6. The printer did come with some white ones. And these are the only other ones I purchased. These are 2x2s. Now, I'm going to order some more. I'm probably going to place another order maybe tomorrow, because I really want to get, it's like a thing you put behind it that you can put your roll on, and it also, you can put your label, your 6x4x6s. Down in the little thing. You'll see. I'm sure I'll show it to you again. But anyway, I want to get that. I want to get a couple more rolls, different rolls of kind. I want to get some shiny ones and maybe some circle ones and so forth. So I want to get a couple different rolls. So y'all, I am loving this, okay? Right now, it is flashing red because I have no paper in there. I wanted to show y'all how I load this in. It's super simple. What you're going to is push the button. And yesterday I was like, okay, I'm thinking while I'm unboxing this, well, that's weird. It won't even say it, but all you got to do is give it a little push and it just will stay right up. These open and shut. I have them set where all I have to do is feed the labels right through. So I'm just going to go ahead and put this behind. You can open this up a little bit and put your label in. I'm going to go ahead and all I'm going to do is kind of pull this close and keep that where it's not pinched, where it has room to work. But that way it'll stay straight. You want to make sure your label here is lined up with the edge of the printer, and all you're going to do is close it. Now that it has the labels, now it's how it turns green, okay? So, I'm going to go ahead, let me see if I can carefully move this over because I have the roll. Now you know why I want to get the stand, so the roll will be there. Okay, so this is what you're going to do whenever you, let me show you. Whenever you scan the little barcode with your tablet or your phone, you're just going to do the initial setup. It's a very simple, all you're going to do is pair it with your device and so forth. And you're gonna add the, you know, you'll download the Munbyn app to your phone or your tablet. So that's what I have here and so forth. Very, very simple. It was very fast and so forth. So anyway, I thought, well, you know what? It's time to break them in. I'm just gonna go for it. So you see how easy it was to load? Very, very simple, y'all. Very simple. Okay. So I want to package up my dog Bandanas, and I've been really thinking about how I'm going to package them up. And so this is what I have come up with. So I've done a couple already, and this is what it looks like. I'm just putting them in plastic sleeves, and I added in a dog cookie, and I'm using my Munbyn printer to put crafty dog Bandanas on that. It was so easy for me to do this. Let me show you how I quickly made that. So I was kind of playing around last night on my Canva. I have Canva. If you don't have Canva, you know, you can just download it. It's super simple. They have a free version. I do have like the pro version. It kind of gives you more options to be able to use other designs if you wish. But this is what I have come up with, okay? So I wanted to make sure, at first I just put dog bandanas, and then I added the extra X small $5. So I'm gonna be selling the small ones, the extra smalls, for $5. Then I'm gonna do like $6 or $7 for the small, and I'm gonna go up like a dollar for each size, because the more material I had to use, the more expensive it cost me to make them. So they don't take long to make, and they didn't take me long to sew. So I'm going to do $5 for extra small, and then mine are going to probably go up to like $11 for the extra large for each one. And it's nice, you get a bonus doggy cookie in the process. Okay, so I just added these in, and let me see if it shows me the, if you're in Canva, this font is called Lubag, if you can see that. And this dog, I actually found it. It was like in one of the designs. I happened to find that. It's three different letters. And then the bandanas is also that same Lubag font. And then the extra small is the same font. I just made it smaller. So from here, all you're going to do is you're going to, I saved it to my device and so forth. So you can go over here and do a save image. There could be a quicker way to do this. But yeah, or not. I might even, while I've got this over here, let me see if I can edit this one and take out the X. And I'm going to do, I think I'll do $6. I think I'll do $6. Let me see, $7. I think I'll do $7 for the small, because it's more fabric. So there we go. Now I have that. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to keep this, and I've tried to keep it all together. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to save it to my tablet, and it's saved probably multiple times. And I'm going to go over here, y'all. There's probably a lot easier ways to do this, but this just works fast for me, and I'm no pro at this. So I'm just going to go for it. Oops. Where did it go? This one. Okay, I'm going to go over to the photos, okay? So here is the photo right here. Say a small $7. And I'm just going to go ahead. I want to resize it while I've got it here. That will make it easier when I, oopsie, come back here, when I get it over into the app. So I just like to kind of play with it a little bit. If you're on your computer, you probably could do things a little bit faster. That looks fairly centered to me. I'm just going to click done. So there we go. Now I'm going to go over here to the Munbyn app. And let me get out of this one, because I've already saved a label. I'm just going to put extra small. Confirm. Okay. That way that one is saved. So now I'm going to go back over here. This is the main. This is what the app looks like whenever you first open it up. You're going to see that your printer is here. That's the kind of printer that I have, and so forth. And you just want to make sure if it's got the green check, that means that it's connected. So now all I'm going to do is go over here and I'm going to hit the plus. And I've already got the label selected, but if you have a different label, you can go over here and you can just select the different labels that you've ordered. And there's different ones. I kind of wish I had the doggy one, but that's okay. I don't have it. I want to do these. So I think this is where I found this one. This is the ones that I have, the square, and this is a 2x2. So there we go. So now I have the appropriate label. Okay. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to go here to the image and select from my tablet. And I am going to do the small one this time. And I'm just going to see if I can make this larger. I want to make sure it's at least centered. That looks okay to me. So it's centered within that sticker size. So now all I'm going to do is do just preview. That looks good. It's centered in my sticker. And y'all, this is the easiest part ever. Let me just see. So I'm going to try moving this back a little bit. because they're going to come out. So I have seven or eight. I'm going to go ahead and print eight. I have eight small dog bandanas. So I'm going to go right here to the number and I'm going to do eight. And now all I'm going to do is I'm going to click print. And look at that. Here comes my stickers. Just beautiful. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to pull it off. I got my crafty dog bandanas. These are the small, so it tells what it is, the size, and the price all in one. Now, I'll be honest, I was going to do it like this. Use the big ones and make it like a topper. And I thought, no, I just want to make it as simple as I can do it and so forth. So this is what I've come up with and I'm loving it. I love it, love it, love it. So I'm not going to use these. These are going away. Okay. So I'm going to move these out of the way because I am done with that for the second. And I've got all my stickers ready to go. Do you see how fast that was? Oh my goodness. Y'all, not sponsored either. I'm just really hyped. They came out nice, centered, and just cute. It's cute. Okay, moving my tablet out of the way. Let me show you how I'm going to package these, okay? I've already got a couple of them done here, okay? So let me show you. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to get a dog biscuit. And I went to the grocery store. I just bought some milk bone. I'm just doing medium size. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take some clear bag because I don't want to just drop the cookie down in there. I want it to be in something because, you know, I still have 2 months till my craft fair. 2.5 months, actually. And I don't want the dog bandana to be smelling like dog cookie, you know. So I want it to stay nice and keep it dry. So I'm going to use these clear bags that I have in my stash. These are 2.25 by 8.5. Of course, I didn't need 8.5 and I cut it off here, but the 2.25 has worked perfectly. I'm going to go ahead and cut it off. And then I'm just going to, you know, try to make sure there's not too much air in there. And I'm just going to fold it down twice. And I am going to just use my tiny attacher. And there we go. So, it's going to have a dog cookie. Now, I'm going to take my clear bags. These are the ones I'm using. I don't know where I got these from, y'all. I'll be honest. But I can tell you that these are 6x9s. That's the size. And I might have got them at Daiso. I might have got them at Hobby Lobby. I don't know where. I've had them in my stash quite a long while. Okay, so I'm going to use one of these to put my dog bandana in. So all I'm going to do is, I wanted to show that it has like it's like the shape, the correct shape. And look at this one. I have a little bit of, where are my scissors? I have a little thread right there. I want to trim that because you want these to look good. So I'm going to go ahead and I just want to fold them kind of like this. I'm going to take it. And I'm going to put it down in my clear bag. Okay. Slipping it down in there. Now, I'll have to use larger bags for the larger ones. So this is probably just going to be medium and the small and extra small size. Okay. And actually, this is an extra small right here. So let me grab my other ones. I'll save these because I was still packaging these. So these are my extra smalls that I already cut. I'm going to go and I'm going to stick my dog cookie down inside. Can I go in? You want to get your air and get the air out so it lays flat. And then I'm going to go and fold that end over. I am going to then take one of my trusty stickers. Now, y'all, this printer only prints, of course, black. But look at that. Easy, right? Easy as that. How fast it was just to package these up. Now they'll stay clean. And they've got the cookie in there. It's ready to go. It is what it is. It's got the size. And, y'all, it's going to be good. So I've got four and I've done these just in minutes. So y'all, I'm loving the Munbyn. I have wanted one of these for quite a long while. I've had it in my Amazon cart for a bit. Now I looked on Munbyn.com and I just decided, you know what, it's gonna be easier just for me to order it on Amazon. I got the printer for $159. So that wasn't too bad at all, and I'm really loving it, and you don't have to put ink in it. It's great. So anyway, that is how I am going to package my dog bandanas. I think that they are precious. This is a great way to do this. I'm gonna put them in a basket. I probably will, maybe I'll use my bear that I had used before, and I'll put a bandana on the bear to show what they look like and so forth. I'm gonna make sure that I have these probably close to where I have a station where people pay me when I'm at the craft fair. I'm gonna probably keep them close. That way then it's easier for me to try to get people to, you know, take a look at them. But anyway, I will have 8 extra small, 8 small, 8 medium, 8 large, and I only have 4 extra large. I might make one or two more because I do have the fabric, but that's probably it of the dog fabric. I'm not going to do anymore because you have to use almost a complete yard. The square is 28 inches. And so that's really close. That's more than 3/4 of a yard. So for a fabric, just for one. So I'm not going to make too many extra larges, but I did want to have some in there. Anyway, that's it. I hope you guys like this. Thanks so much for stopping by. And I hope that you enjoyed this. And if you're new, welcome. And if you've been around, welcome back. I love you guys. And I just really appreciate each and every one of you. I really do. And yeah, that's it. Have a great night, y'all. And I'll catch you in my next one. Love you guys. Bye.